I am reaching out to you today from the very sunny Zadar, and as you know, I do not like the sun. I'm a true desi, that's why I'm walking in shade. Anyways, the best part about staying in the Netherlands is to be able to travel to any country within Europe within just like 2 hours, 3 hours. Today we took 1.5 hour flight from home, and now we are here in Zadar, in Croatia. And now we are out about to explore beautiful Zadar. There are quite a few famous touristy things, which I am going to stick to only them, those things in this vacation, because I have my parents and I have a toddler with me. But what I'm going to do is give you an honest opinion about the touristy things here. How are they worth the hype or not? So one of those things is the Riva Promenade and the sea organ, which is basically Ganara Samut, which is basically the sea that sings. So let's go and see that. This is definitely giving me quite a bit of vacation vibes. I finally feel like I'm on vacation. Friday evening, by the way, so I was guessing that there would be a lot of crowds, but not too many. And I am giving my parents a guiding tour talking about the history of Croatia, but I don't know how true it is, and I'm very scared to put that on the internet. So you guys just enjoy the views, and for guidance please reach out to Google. We are back out of the alleys, and every time I walk, black cat. So we are on our way to watch the sea organ, but I think from our apartment towards the sea organ, we kind of got lost in these alleys, and I'm very happy that we did, because as you saw in the footage earlier, like, these are kind of a very nice vibe. Those people are just chilling, nice cafes, cute restaurants, people are just sitting and enjoying. Definitely gives a bit of a local feel. At least I think those are locals sitting there and enjoying their food. But it was really nice. So I'll leave the link to the street where we were walking for you if you're coming next time to explore. Zadar is supposed to have one of the most beautiful sunsets in the world, and it is not even sunset, but I can totally imagine. Look at this. I can totally imagine why they say that. Waiting for the sunset, and we came to see the sea organ, but honestly it is not that I think it is hyped up a lot. You have to listen very carefully, because I am sitting right in front of those holes which make those music, but I still have to like listen very carefully, only then I can see it. So sea organ, it's okay, but now we are waiting for the sunset, and I know for sure that is going to be really gorgeous, because already this place looks so nice, and with the sun which is not even set, it just looks magical. Definitely it was the most beautiful sunset that I actually have ever seen in my life. But so if you can see, that's the sun, and that's the sea level where it should have been set, but there is a cloud in between here, so it was a sunset in the cloud and not sunset in the sea. Nevertheless, still the most beautiful sunset that I have seen in my life. So apparently the sun came out of the clouds and was setting inside the sea. I'm a person who normally, even where I live, if you tell me, I take like 1000 pictures of the sunset, irrespective of whether it is special or not. But if you tell me on my travels there is a special sunset, there is 100% guarantee that I'm going to sit there and take a time lapse. Enjoy. Apparently there is this monument which stores the solar light, and then in the evening there is light coming out of that. But there are a lot of kids playing, and I do not like to take kids in the video, you know, to respect their privacy. So the seaside promenade are over. Now the next biggest task wherever a desi travels abroad is to find food. There are no Indian restaurants here, but we want to have vegetarian food, of course, because I have my parents with me. I have actually, my husband has already started distrusting my options, but I have found a couple of them. Let's see if they live up to the ratings that they have on Google, and I hope we find vegetarian food here. The restaurant we had to go was quite full. They did not have any tables, neither they had any servers. And nevertheless, we are going to one place. I think it is like a chain of fast foods here. I don't know. Vegetarians ka sahara bread when you go to any new country. There is a famous bread, or I don't know, pastry that they call here, which is called as burek. I could see a lot of locals buying that in the local bakery where I got this bread. But it's made of cheese, and I had a lot of cheese today, so I'll pass on that. But it was nice to see the locals buying. And also one more thing, if you are coming to Zadar, remember, or in Croatia, they are very high on using cash. Like for example, when I had to buy this bread, the pin or card wasn't working. So if you are planning to come here, make sure that you bring some cash along with you. I am definitely loving the night scene here of Zadar more than the day scene. Everything looks so much more prettier. We were here a couple of hours ago, and it looked nice, of course, with the blue seas and all, but look at it in the night time. So pretty, isn't it? Anyways, I am tired. Reality of a toddler mom traveling. We are going back to the apartment. I hope you guys like this vlog. But for now, bye bye from beautiful Zadar. I'll see you in the next vlog.